Welcome back to Let's Play Enderal, Forgotten Stories Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari.
It's the Prophetess, isn't it?
And it's the Prophetess. And I'm returning the items. The Shimmering Alloy, also known as Sakabaku Alloy, and the Pyrian Crystal Cube to Kurmai here.
Well, any luck?
Yes, so you can fix your ship.
Transcribe verse 80 100 times.
I've asked him about the ship and the cycle before. I found the alloys, at least I think so.
Perfect, that's them. Good work.
Why, thank you. And you were right about the cube. It was in the old ruin.
Ah, he thought so. Very good work. Your reputation is well deserved.
That would be everything, right?
Yes, he didn't expect it. But you and your order have been of great assistance indeed. Give him one more day and Gertrude will fly through the heavens like a fairy. Ah, and you should go to the captain's cabin before you leave. Your Grand Master arrived a short while ago, and it seems he wants to talk to you.
Alright, I think we can sleep in there too. Nothing new. I talked to him about this stuff. Alright. Alright, yeah, it's funny the way he talks. He's the first starling that I encountered, so I figured they all talk like that. But no, I think he's the only one who says he instead of me and I. Funny that. Don't see anything new here. Does this place look a little different? Or maybe not.
Prophetess, have you found the missing pieces?
Yes. I've already given them to Kurmai. He said the ship should be ready to fly in a day.
Good. According to Kurmai, your journey will last 2 days.
Okay.
I've instructed him to first head for the Nexus Tower.
The Nexus Tower?
According to the Starling writings, this is where the ancient fathers kept all their knowledge. The heart of the Star City, so to speak. Ah, and you will not be traveling on your own. The mercenaries, Sakharesh, Magistra Yaela, and her adjutant will accompany you. I expect you to be back at the temple in 1 week, with knowledge about the Numinas.
You expect me, huh? Will Ark withstand the siege from the Nuremes in the meantime?
As long as Shirim's barriers are holding, yes. However, we should not rely on them.
Better be safe than sorry. Where are the others?
They will be there when the ship leaves. Before you go, however, I suggest you return to Ark to properly equip yourself. Who knows what you will be facing up there?
I think I have everything I need, actually. I'll just wait. So exciting. I brought the missing components to Kurmai. Gertrude should be ready for departure shortly. Go to the airship. Well, I was already in the thing, and now I'm over here for some reason. Oh. Yeah, that was foolish. That was a little foolish. What do I have? Oh, I thought it said I have grilled cheese for a second. I saw it wrong. Oh, you were hanging out over there, huh?
An expedition to the Star City. I never thought I'd see the day.
You really?
Good luck, Prodigy. Bring us the answers we're looking for.
And have a safe journey.
Wait, I think I know you. You helped the Grandmaster crush those Nerami's bastards at the Harbor Gate, didn't you?
Where'd the other guy go?
I can't believe that actually happened.
An expedition to the Star City.
And here I thought the Star City was
a
myth. Live and learn, I guess.
Well, it's all too real. Interact with deactivated starlings. Spider is spelled wrong.
An expedition to the Star City. I never thought I'd see the day.
So I could interact with them? It went away, though. Alright, never mind. That was weird.
Walk blessed.
Ah, you. We were told you'd be coming. You're from Nerim as well, aren't you? Ah,
no,
just
no.
Curious. I'd really like to know if they've made it to the heavens. It's a fascinating piece of technology. It
seen
truly
that
is.
Conversation.
If only oh, Shari could see this.
I have to remember that.
So they deactivated the spiders because they're complete here. Oh, hey. Good. Just bar. And
on their way look back, who's here. Talk to Kurmai if you're ready to start. He's just waiting for your signal.
I didn't say you'd be here.
Yes. They won't be steering anything, to be precise. Because Gertrude flies on her own as soon as the coordinates have been set. He thanks you, Tialor Aranthiel. Any other Grand Master would have laughed at him,
Calia.
But you have listened instead. Now he will be the first of his people to meet the Ancient Fathers. It is hard to believe that. Walk blessed, and all the best for your fight.
Thank you. The others are expecting you. Ah, and there's one more thing. This amulet belonged to my son. I want you to have it. Wear it or not, the choice is yours. Now leave. And do not disappoint me.
Nerissel's brooch. Well, now I have an amulet that I could give to Lorem Waterblade. But I don't think we can leave now. The cooldown of talents is reduced by 20%. I can't wear it because it would deactivate Lorem. So, and I don't know if he could actually make use of it, talents.
The last passenger has arrived. That is a pleasure.
I thank you. Kalia's over here. Hey.
Saira, it's good to see you.
Good to see you too. Nothing else to say.
Saira.
Okay.
It's good to see you.
We're going in, what does it say? Nothing new. Alright. Going up this way? I just want to see if anything changed in the rest of the ship. Interact with Starling device. Oh. I can't turn it off. Can't turn it off. It's gotta do its run its course, apparently. Wait, that goes out. It's telling me to go out. Can't be right. Maybe it is. I wasn't not supposed to go in here yet? Ugh. Yeah, I wasn't paying attention to somebody. Oh! I didn't even realize this was up here. Hi.
Welcome aboard. How are things going? Are you ready?
Yes. Let's begin.
Well then. All aboard! Then raise the ramp! She's taking off!
Wow. The ramp has been
and
raised.
There we go. Good. Very good.
How do we get out of this cave, though? He looks happy.
Fly!
Oh wait, we've got... Oh, it's open up top. We'll witness this together. Wow. I love this. Speak with Jesper on the starship's deck.
Well, look who's here. How are you?
Talk to Jesper or go to sleep? I'm on a flying ship on my way to the home of the ancient starlings. I'd say I'm excited.
Yes, excited. I guess I feel the same. Well... Did you want something in particular, or are you just looking for some company?
Just making chit-chat. The Grandmaster told me you've been researching the Star People's culture for decades. Why, when you are not a Starling yourself?
You're right. But on the other hand, do you have to be a mummy in order to dedicate yourself to archaeology?
Good point.
The Starlings. I have been fascinated by them since I was a child. You must know... Their technology is so powerful that if they wanted to, they could probably conquer the entire civilized world with it. But they don't. And why? Because they all share the same dream instead.
The dream of fulfilling the old prophecies and returning home.
Exactly. A place without war or hunger, where all are born equal and enjoy the same rights, regardless of their standing in society.
Sounds wonderful.
And for some reason, this thought has fascinated me as much as the Starlings themselves do. Call it a fantasy, but if there is such a place, if it really is like the old legends, we'd be able to learn so much from the ancient fathers. And, well, there it is, the answer to your question. I suppose that this naive hope is the reason for my interest in the Star People's culture.
Do you believe that such a society is even possible?
Well, that is a good question. I guess we'll have to wait until we find one. Anyway, let us continue our conversation at a later time, shall we? I want to enjoy the night sky. Who knows how many more chances we will have.
Right. Wow. Anyone else out here? Lishem?
Quite a view, isn't it? I really wish the war and the High Ones weren't casting shadows over all of this. This world can be so beautiful.
Got that right. Kurmai?
Yes? What do you want?
Trying to interact with the deactivated spider. You have my respect. To be honest, I doubted that this machine would actually be able to fly.
Yes, he had his doubts too. Yet do not admire him, but rather those who came up with the schematics for this ship. Every single piece of Gertrude is based on the research of hundreds, maybe thousands of brave Starling researchers.
We've been airborne for more than a day now. Have we? About when do you think we'll arrive?
It will take some more time. Use it to stretch your legs or to talk to your friends. You will know when it is time.
What do you think is waiting for us in the Star City?
Well, peace, hopefully. Forgive him, but he has no better answer.
I asked him this already, right?
He does have help, but indeed, according to your standards, he did it on his own. You know, many things become possible when one uses brains instead of muscles.
I'm gonna talk to him. I wanna find Calia first, though. I don't know if she's in here. I guess we don't... That might be like a... A backup pilot? Or sleep. Oh. I'm not turning that thing on because I can't. I can't turn it back off. Where's Calia? I mean, she's got to be around here. She can't have, like, jumped off or anything. It was Taylor or Ranthiel, for that matter. Kurmai? Nijam? She was standing here by this hay. Hela. I don't see her. Well, what's up, Jaspar?
It's a crazy world, isn't it?
What do you mean?
On our way to a forgotten city in the clouds, and I'm part of it. It just sounds surreal. But anyway, it's good that you're here. I wanted to talk to you. Do you have a second?
I wouldn't be here if I didn't, would I?
You have a point there. How should I put it? I wanted to thank you. I'm not sure if you know it, but all that's happened since I plucked you out of that thicket on the Sun Coast, it did something to me.
Plucked me out of the thicket?
I think I've understood something, as corny as it may sound.
What?
It's hard to put into words. You know, I still believe what I told you that time we met at the Dancing Nomad. That we all act as we do because we hope it makes us happy. But somehow, in no small part thanks to my father, I've always considered responsibility and being happy to be contradictory. But actually, that's wrong. It's the exact opposite. In order to be truly content, we need connection. To a person, to a cause, to anything. If you never find that, you'll never find yourself.
Okay. Well, that's certainly a change of tune compared to what you said at the Silver Cloud, that we're born alone and we die alone.
Yeah, I said that. And I still think it's true to an extent. You're on your own if you want to be. I'm responsible for what happened to Adela and to Lysia, because I never wanted to be responsible. Sounds strange, doesn't it? But I can't change what happened. I'll just have to live with that.
So what you're essentially saying is, we all need something to live for, right?
Maybe. Maybe not. In the end, I can only speak for myself. The fact is, though, that it... I don't know. That it feels like I owe this world to be right here, right now. As part of something momentous.
Part of something momentous.
And I like how that feels. That surprises me. No matter how all this ends, I will have no regrets.
That's great.
Same goes for our friendship. That's what I wanted to tell you. Despite all the trouble we got ourselves into, I'm glad that our paths crossed. For whatever reason they did.
Well, the feeling's mutual.
Thanks. But anyway, enough of this sentimental babble for now. You should probably rest a little. Who knows what awaits us up there?
True. True. True that. Speak with Calia. So what are your thoughts on the current events?
Short answer? We're screwed. With this fanatical madman in front of our gates, our time's running out. And all these possessed people on the streets don't exactly make it better. We have to ignite the beacon, and we have to do it fast. Else... Let's not talk about it.
Right. Okay. Alright, see you, friend. Contrary to the expectations of quite a few people, Kurmai's airship really flew, and now we are traveling to the lost homeland of the Starlings called Star City. According to Kurmai, the journey will take around 3 days. I should use the time to rest and prepare myself for what's to come. And now we've got this. According to Kurmai, it still takes at least 1 day until we arrive at the Star City. However, it will look like. Maybe now would be a good time to talk with Calia while she recovered from her breakdown in the Scuola. I think that the events in the castle still burden her very much. Alright. So this is a little side thing then. I never figured out this. The fragments. If I get a chance to. I don't know if we're coming back from this. So she's in here. So now I'll actually find her in here. Hey!
Saira, how are... Okay, let's just skip the small talk. I was never good at that. I wanted to see you because there's something I need to show you. Follow me.
Okay.
I couldn't sleep, so I used the chance to take a look around. The thought that Kurmai did this all by himself... It's incredible.
I know.
It would take dozens of Enderalian craftsmen at least 5 years to do this.
Probably been all his life he's done it. Oh, I couldn't get in here before.
Are you ready?
What? This must be the way the ship's machinery is, right? Isn't it?
Yeah, but just bear with me. You'll be surprised. Ready to go in?
I guess so, yeah.
Good.
You gonna pull that? It didn't work when I pulled it. You got magic chain pulling powers. Wow.
Kurmai told me about this place. This sphere is what keeps us in the air, and it draws its energy from the water. Crystal water, that's what he called it.
Crystal water?
I just had to see it for myself.
Now you're showing me, thank you. Is it safe to get close to this thing?
It's beautiful, don't you think?
So this thing is all that keeps us from crashing right back down to Earth? That's comforting.
I absolutely agree. You...
What?
He just can't believe it. No, he just can't believe it.
What?
Oh, damn.
Let me guess. We shouldn't be down here.
No, quickly, run.
We're running? Running further in.
That should do it. Now, wait a second.
Do you know how to sneak?
What part of vertical didn't you understand? He thinks his instructions were clear. Stay here. Do nothing. But no. You decide to run around the ship and open whatever door crosses your path. And no. Don't look at him like
that.
Next time, there will be consequences.
He wasn't talking to us. There will be consequences. Sounds like a certain danger lord.
Well, okay.
Saved by the bell, I guess.
Yes.
Oh my god, you're actually laughing. I've never seen that happen.
Saira, that... I just...
That is pretty funny, isn't it? Are you laughing or just... What are you laughing about?
I... Oh, by the name of the sun, I just can't believe it. Here we are, on a mission to save mankind, and instead of sharpening our weapons and talking gloomily... We play hide and seek, like two little kids who just stole an apple from their neighbor. That's just bizarre, isn't it?
Life is what you make it, right? Well, as far as I know, Gloomy Talk hasn't won any battles yet.
No, it hasn't. Anyway, I guess we're safe down here, at least for a while. But actually, I don't mind. This place, it makes me feel serene. Lets you forget why we're here.
It's true. What happened to you, by the way? You seem different.
Do I? In a good or bad way?
In a good way.
That's good to hear. You know, Sayira, I've been thinking about what happened in the castle and the talk we had after that.
Oh, yeah? What's your conclusion of your thinking?
Well, do you remember when I said that I should maybe just give up and accept that I'll never be able to fully control that thing inside me?
Yeah?
You tried to comfort me and told me that what happened in the castle was just an accident. And that with just enough tenacity, I could make sure it would never happen again.
You can do it.
At first I was grateful, but then I thought about it and realized that there was actually some truth in what I had said. You know, all my life, I've tried to kill that part of me because it made me feel despicable. And every time I failed, I hated myself for it and thought that I was just too weak. But that was the wrong way to look at it from the very start. This thing, the only way to truly kill it would be to kill myself.
Don't do that.
And I can't and won't do that.
Good.
Not now, when there's so much at stake, nor in the future if there is one.
What are you trying to say then, that you're just going to let it run free?
No, I won't let it harm anyone ever again. But I'll accept that it's a part of me. You know, Sayira, what good did all the self-loathing ever do? I've been dealt a tough hand, and with that thing and these urges inside of me, I'll never be like the others.
What am I doing?
I think that's the best, maybe the only way to deal with something like this. Accept it, as despicable as it may be, because it is part of who you are. Do you understand what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm not deluding myself. Living with this thing will be something I have to wrestle with for the rest of my life. There will always be moments of weakness when it will try to get the best of me. But I will always resist. And I will do so without condemning myself every time it happens. And in the meantime, I will live. I will do all the things that I never allowed myself to do. Build friendships, go see the world, and go dancing.
Dancing?
Even if the latter would be a rather amusing sight.
Don't forget sneaking around skyships.
Yes. And that.
Well, what about me? Am I a part of your plans?
You are, if you want to be.
I wouldn't have it any other way.
That really means a lot to me, Sayira. You know, I'm not sure I could have... why am I still talking?
Aw. He's kissing my head. Okay. Sound like clothes came off. What? My clothes came off. Oh, her clothes came off. Well, I can't talk to her like that. Can I sit down? No. I'll stand in the water and talk to you so I can get a better look at you, I guess. Good morning. I know we said we'd be here, safe here for a while, but apparently decided to spend several hours here, sleeping and doing other things. Good morning.
Hey, sorry I didn't wake you earlier. You seemed exhausted.
I've been fighting a lot of stuff. It's actually been ages since I last... slept? I needed it. Actually, it hasn't been that long.
I guess so. I heard talking coming from upstairs, and I think it could be time to go back to the others. What do you say?
I say at first we should put our clothes on. One more thing. How do you feel about all this? About us?
Good, I suppose. But truth be told, I'm also afraid. You know, to make a mistake. All of this, it's new to me, and it happened quickly. There you were, there were these feelings, and then this.
Hope you don't mind me asking this, but is this really the first time you've been with somebody in a romantic sense?
The first time the other person felt the same way, yes. There was a girl once, when I was younger. A novice. Silva.
Okay. Is she a keeper now, too?
No. It hurts me to say it, but she lacked the discipline for it. She's an adjutant to a priestess now, and I don't even know if she's still on Enderal.
And she didn't reciprocate your feelings, I take it?
Well, let's put it this way. I'd be surprised if she even knew I existed. This was before that farmer told everyone about my connection to that village. I was very introverted back then, and preferred to spend most of my time alone. So, I was just like I am nowadays.
I get it.
Still, these feelings I had for her, they made me afraid. They were just there, all of a sudden, and they seemed so intense and unreasonable. I couldn't control them, and that drove me crazy.
And how do you feel about what's between us?
That's different. Between us, it was somehow slower. More like some sort of trust, some sort of affection, which grew with each passing day. Especially through the talks we had.
I don't think that's a bad thing.
No, it isn't. I think if I had felt the same towards you as I did towards Silva, I would have done one thing. Backed off. Meditated. Killed these feelings bit by bit so that they couldn't gain control over me. The fact that it wasn't like that, it's what made all this possible. You know, Saira, you were there for me. You accepted me despite everything you knew about me. And honestly, until the very end, I thought that there had to be some catch to it. Some logical reason for your affection. I just couldn't imagine you did it because... well, you know. Anyway, to be honest, for once in my life, I don't want to think about my feelings too much. I'm just happy. And that's it.
That's good. And just go with it, you know? So what's the plan from here on out?
I don't know. Hopefully one that includes the two of us being together.
I agree.
First, we have to put an end to the cycle. Find the Numinos, light the beacon, and then... I can't imagine that this Quarek will just set sail and go back to Nerim once we've destroyed his vision of a higher existence for mankind, which essentially means war. But let's be honest, Saira. We can't win. Not against Nerim.
Well, we can't run either. Maybe we'll find another way once we've stopped the High Ones. We'll see.
Yes, we'll see. For now, I'd say that we should focus on getting rid of the High Ones first.
Exactly.
Do you want to go upstairs now? The others will be waiting for us.
All right, let's go.
Good. I'd recommend a little clothing first.
Yeah.
I don't think the others would like this look as much as I do.
Nah.